Hello, this is Jake from the Corona team, and in the next few minutes, you'll be able to use Corona Image Editor to modify renders without having 3ds Max or Cinema 4D open. Corona Image Editor is a standalone application that comes with Chaos Corona. It allows us to load renders that have been saved as CXR files, and then we can apply any of the post-production operations which are available in the Corona Virtual Frame Buffer. If we want to be able to denoise in the Corona Image Editor, make sure we select Gather Data for later before we hit render in our application. And if we'd like to use LightMix, then make sure we've got that set up before hitting render. We can load CXR files using the Open button. And if we made any edits to the LightMix or had multiple suns in the scene, then the beauty may look a little overblown. So make sure we choose LightMix Interactive from the Render Elements dropdown. Corona Image Editor is very similar to the Virtual Frame Buffer that we would find in Cinema 4D or 3ds Max when using Corona. We can modify our tone mapping, bloom and glare, sharpening and blurring, as well as denoising and editing our light mix. And all of this without the need to re-render and without running any 3D software. If we had light mix set up in our renders, then the layers will be included under our light mix tab. And here you can make changes to the lighting and even save and load various lighting scenarios. And it's worth noting that you can load and save tone mapping and light mix setups freely between the Virtual Frame Buffer and the Corona Image Editor. To use denoising, let's head to the denoising dropdown, and you can choose denoise or you can click on custom denoise. And custom denoise is going to let us choose which render element should be denoised and which type of denoising to use. Denoising render elements uses RAM, so if we're looking to save some resources, then deselecting some render elements is an option. And when using Gather for later, we'll get the choice of Corona High Quality or Firefly Removal. And if we want to use either of the AI denoise options, then one of them needs to be selected back in the host application before rendering and in place of Gather Data for later. It doesn't matter which of the two AI denoises you select at render time, Intel or Nvidia, you'll be able to choose either once you're in the Corona Image Editor. For more on denoising modes, see the denoising how-to video. Once we hit denoise, the denoising will take place. And denoising later in Corona Image Editor is particularly useful when rendering high-res images or images that have a lot of light mix layers to be denoised, as these would use a lot of RAM. By using denoise later, you don't need that extra memory while rendering in 3ds Max or Cinema 4D, and that might allow a problematic scene to fit into memory at render time when it would otherwise require too much. Once completed, we can adjust the denoising amount, 1 being a fully denoised image and 0 being an undenoised image. The default is 0.65 and tends to give us good results. Also note that by denoising later in the Corona Image Editor, we're able to adjust the radius parameter to fine-tune the results. And normally this is locked in at render time when you do the denoising in the Virtual Frame Buffer, and it would require a complete re-render to adjust this parameter. So the Corona Image Editor can be useful when the client comes back to you with a change request for a project that you've already finished rendering. It means you don't have to open 3ds Max or Cinema 4D, and you don't need to re-render your scene if you want to make edits to your post-production, your denoising, or your light mix. It can also help if you're working on a computer with less RAM by reducing the RAM needed at render time by saving denoising for later. Just be sure to save your images as CXRs to take advantage of any of these benefits. Thanks for watching, and make sure you check out our other videos to keep exploring what Corona can do for you.